game.
No, you can't do it. 51-49. Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live on Channel 4. That was one of next week's guests, Rita Ora. How we do? Looking forward to that.
I am looking forward to that.
Seeing her next week. Welcome to Sarts Museum's first inventor in residence, Mark Chapkins. I'm just doing a bit of business with him there. I've got an idea for an invention. 51-49 is the split. anyway, so you're here to talk about Make It in Great Britain exhibition, which is running at the moment.
Yes, it's on at the Science Museum. And if we won Olympic medals for invention, we'd be sort of top of the table. So what we're doing at the Science Museum is showing off all the best of British manufacturing, engineering, inventions. And yeah, it runs till September.
And we are quite brilliant.
We are
inventing, aren't we?
Absolutely brilliant, yeah.
What would you say is your top three British inventions of all time?
I think the cat's eye is absolutely brilliant because it's a simple, elegant solution.
Everyone always says the cat's eye.
They clean themselves as well. If you run them over, the little kind of glass bits get cleaned. Yeah. I think that's absolutely brilliant.
They do a little scream as well. They go, ow! Ow!
Is it true as well that the guy who invented them also did a deal that he would get paid per unit? And when he first did it, and he still is getting paid, or his family still getting paid per unit?
I think that's probably true.
Yeah.
Okay, what's the next one?
The next one, I think, would be the jet engine.
Yes.
Fantastic. Yes. It was a real sort of...
ruining the world, but...
they're getting better.
Apart from that...
and they're getting us around.
Gets us around. And finally?
And then finally, just because of the impact that it's had on the world, penicillin. So 200 million lives saved by penicillin.
You go to the doctor, you say, I'm ill, you don't want him sticking needles in, you want to... penicillin, that's what you want, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Because you know it works.
It does work.
Okay, so how are we in the world of inventions at the moment? Is it a boom industry?
Yeah, it is. Actually, the patent office are registering more patents now than ever before. So there is an increase. It might be because that kind of make-do-amend, people are in the recession coming up with more ideas. You know, they say necessity is the mother of invention, so who knows? It could be that.
Maybe certain show that you might have appeared on once, Dragon's Den, might have something to do with it.
Yeah, perhaps, yeah.
So you're an inventor yourself. What have you invented?
I've done lots of different things. I've done self-heating crockery was my first invention. And then for Dragon's Den, I did a whole range of products that help kids to concentrate when they're at school so they can eat more sort of healthy foods and drink more water and sit more comfortably. And then for the Science Museum, I've done some really simple things that encourage kids to sort of inquire about things and think. So I've done levitating cutlery, so placemats with magnets and the cutlery floats. And then I've done these, which are, I thought about Word documents, and that counts the number of words that you've done. I thought it'd be nice to do that in an analog way. So I've made these pencils. I measured a pencil really accurately, wrote 1,000 words, measured it again, and then worked out from there that if you wear it out to here, you'd have done 10,000 words.
That's
to here,
brilliant.
20,000
I love
words.
That. That's
brilliant.
That's a really great invention.
Good idea. Well, going back to the school one, I think you know, I love the fact that you're trying to make it interesting. I do think it's down to parents and schools to make kids eat healthily.
Yes, yeah, I think so. And Jamie Oliver as well.
But I think what he's doing is a good job. So there you go. Anyway, so as an inventor yourself, what skills do you have to be an inventor? What do you need to be an inventor?
That's a good question. I think you need to be...
But you have to know the inside. We've got something we'll show in a minute, but you need to know the inside out.
It helps to have some knowledge about things. And I think also the other thing is noticing. If you're wandering around, noticing opportunities, noticing when things don't work, you know, noticing when things could be done better is a real good way.
There's two levels of inventor then. Because say, for example, as a parent, I always think that, you know, you would always think, oh, I wish you could find something that would do X, Y, Z. So that's almost like an invention comes through necessity of yourself, as opposed to you saying, right, how can I actually make the world more interesting or better? Do you think there's two different things?
I think they're sort of the same approach, in that you're trying to make things better, either because you want to make it more interesting or just because you're irritated.
Which is mine. I've been banging on about this for about 10 years. It's the whisker suit.
Okay,
you have electric charge. Whiskers coming for electric charge, so you can maintain your you know, your personal space.
Oh really?
What, on the tube. Yes, if anyone comes near you, electrocutes them. And you go, you'd have to speak to them. You can just go, dong, electrocute. What do you think?
I think that could make a bit of money. Yeah.
It's great.
In the right hands.
Give it to kids, make them travel home safely at night. Everyone has electric thing. Anyway, look, these are some of the proper inventions. Okay. This one here is actually in the exhibition. What's this?
This is Micropox. So this is a British company.
Yep.
They're leading the way in the world in self-diagnosis. So this particular one, you can tell what blood group you are.
Brilliant.
So you buy them at the chemist or the doctors would have them, and it's a really, really quick way, so the lab doesn't have to analyse.
We want to move on, because we've actually got the inventor here. This is Arnold. Do you want to come in? Yeah. Why don't you quickly explain what this is?
Sure. Well, hi, everybody.
Hi.
It's Arnold. Yay!
Woo!
Right, well, what we have here is the world's first ever hop-on golf trolley.
This is brilliant. Go
so
on.
This is a UK-built product.
Who have you built it for? What sort of people?
This is actually for any golfers. So yeah, any golfer.
But in mind, would you think in golfers that are maybe getting old?
Some of the senior golfers?
Yeah, right.
Maybe
lazy golfers.
Yeah, lazy golfers. Not quite. Actually, this is more for the interactive golfer, the one who might want to get around the course faster.
And how does it work?
And this one is actually just as it is right now. It's an electric push trolley. So you just walk with it like this.
Nasha's getting on it. Yeah.
And then this one has a unique function. If you pull that tab, it opens her up. And you can literally just hop on and wave people goodbye.
That is brilliant. That is brilliant.
Is very, very clever.
That's brilliant. Get it up so I can have a little go on it.
Are you a little bit jealous of that, Mark, that you didn't invent?
Yeah, I am.
So where can you see this? Where can you see this? Where can you go to the exhibition?
At the Science Museum until the 9th of September.
OK, time for an extraordinary story involving one man's obsession with collecting some of the planet's most dangerous animals. This is brilliant, this. This is America's animal hoarder horror at the zoo. Good. Right, this way. Yes!